and school board members Rob Houston and Valerie Mishla. Welcome to tonight's CIF game. Ladies and gentlemen, if we could please rise for our national anthem. Presenting the colors are MJROTC from Santa Ana High School. breaking, money making, soul taking, history making, Santa Ana marching band. Under the direction of Mr. Victor Villasantos and Mr. De La Quadra, and our fantastic color guard and presentation of colors.
That's not a good place to start off. offense by Santa Ana just performing all over them. Nowhere to go. Santa Ana's got a great athletes. They fight in the football. No gain on the play. So we third and 20, third and 20. Sweep to the right side of the line. Great pursuit by the defense. Great first hit the defense by Santa Ana High School. So early in the ball game, be fourth and 18. Damian Macias is back to return. He's a dangerous football player. Not only that, he's a dangerous returner. He's a great athlete. Gets the punt off, get pressure. Takes a nice roll. All right, nice roll, it's a nice punt. First down at 22-yard line, Saints have the football. It's great for a series.
We have a senior Aguilar split out white. Aguirre split out. Along with Chris Nava, quarterback to see us.
Macias the quarterback, they're dangerous. They got Jarvis in the background. They got the very dangerous receivers. And so it's great fun to watch. There goes Brazil with the ball. Like I said, very explosive. His first step getting off the ball. First down. That's what Santa Ana Saints do so well. They attack the holes with quickness and power. First and 10.
Alan Pacheco with the carry,
number 4. Alan Pacheco, number 20, 4-yard gain on the play.
Tackled by number 5, Sheehan Ramirez.
Second and around 6. There goes Brazilis for a long run. Like I said, he's very quick and explosive. Another 7-yard gain on the play. Like I said, Santa explosives coming right at him. That's a great play by the defensive end on this side. Dominique Wilson with a great play.
Pablo Aguirre with the carry, loss on the play. Second down. Live on the play, we have a holding call against the Saints.
That's a holding guard, sends out a tackle back 15 yards.
Don't forget.
Looks like second and 14. Sees his back at the ball. He can throw. He's a very talented kid. That's a nice play by number 20, the defensive end for La Hambra. It's third and around 14. Third and around 14.
Third and 14 for the Saints.
see it's in the shotgun. Rolls out to the left. That's good hitting, good team defense on that side. Good defense on that side. So they make around third and around 11. And the ball's on the 20-yard line. It's fourth and 11. Look like Santa Ana's going for it. That wasn't even ready. And he missed it. Believe it or not, the kicker was looking down the ground. He wasn't even ready when they hiked the football. Like I said, it's the first round CF game.
Fumble the key is knocked out of bounds by number 21, Isaiah Guzman.
Like I said, it's a little jitters, still a little jitters. The CF's got great hands, great athlete. They're going to pick the ball up and make. Brought it back to the line of scrimmage, so we have now 2nd and 10.
Lost about a yard in the play.
Another bad stop. He knocked out another bad stop. Like the ball's back in the 5-yard line. They're gonna have to get that center to the quarterback. The snaps, they gotta get their snaps back. So they're going backwards.
3rd and 23.
Like I said, the Saints are backed up to the goal line. A draw to Brazina. That was a good defensive series by the Hammer football team. Santa Ana's gonna have to punt the ball back out.
Brings us to 4th and 23.
4th and 23.
Big play. 3rd and 6 for the Moors.
have his third in around six. He pitches it back. That's good pursuit by the defense. That's a good job. There's nowhere to run. They had everything plugged, so there's nowhere to go. It'd be fourth and around six. I have some punting teams coming out. Like I said, Messiah is a dangerous punt returner. He took three or four touchdowns back to the house. So I'm an ex-alumni, so I keep up with the set in high school. So he's a talented kid. All right, 36 yard line, first and 10. All right, Santa's first and 10. They got trips out this way. Score 0-0. Both teams had opportunity to score, so that's what it's all about. Santa has the ball back. You see he's back in the shotgun position. He throws to the outside. Beautiful pass, choir catch. Nice pass and catch by Messias and Empire. Flag on that, but the referee didn't call it, but as long as they're playing within the whistle. That's the end of the first quarter. Second quarter, second and one to go. Second and one. That's first down there. First down Pacheco. 4 yard run. First down Saints. Split out.
Pacheco Briseño is in the backfield with Macias.
The second and round four. That's a great run by Macias. He's a smart runner. The reason I believe he does go outside, he does not want to, you know, risk an injury. So he's getting much what he can and getting out of there. So very heads up player on his behalf. Very smart football player. I'm so proud of him to come back from an injury where I guess he's had surgery. And he came back even stronger. So look out, future. He's coming. Back to pass again, throw it. Great second effort, but that's a great up hit. Sometimes it's smart to go down. That's the reason why. That's one of the reasons why you need to go down. You pay the price. That ball gets a lot of attention. Great drive by the San Diego Saints. Hopefully they can capitalize this time going in. Second and around three. Plug that hole right there. Good defensive front.
No gain. Third down. Timeout, Santa Ana.
Make him jump outside, but good discipline on the Hammers football team. Like we got a timeout right now. Let's go.
First and goal, the ball's in the 4-yard line.
it's going in. Touchdown Saints. 4-yard run by George Rosenio.
Thank you.
good coverage by the Saints. That's good secondary coverage. There was nowhere to throw the ball, so that's great coverage. I call that a secondary sack. It's 3rd and 17. 8:45 to go in the second quarter. They got some trips lined out to the side here. Alright, so incomplete pass, that'll make it 4th and around 18. Messias back returning the punt. Like I said, he's one of the dangerous punt returners in Orange County this year. Come from a great athletic family. His older brother Louis was a great Saint. He's up at Oregon State right now. That's almost a block. Great field position for Sinan. I like the ball going the 40. 42 yard line. Alright, here we go. Center has the ball. Let's see, it's in the shotgun position. We got trips to the side. And he's going long, overthrown him, overthrown.
Pass incomplete to Briseño.
So that'd be 2nd and 10. Ball's on the 41-yard line. Inside. We got dive. George outside. Ooh, we got a little late hit out of bounds, but hey, no calls. Look like the it's first down. Okay, we got slot to the top of the right of the screen. It's another dive, number 20.
Donald Pacheco with the carry, gain of about 3.
2nd and 7. This is a shotgun. Phone ball picks it up. He pitches it. I think the Saints might have got it back. First down.
First and 10, center has the ball, 20-yard line.
If Erie knocked out of bounds, Mayram Hernandez to the press box.
That's a 4-yard gain in the play. Like that guy, Aguirre, number 17, is a tough receiver. He doesn't catch the ball and go down. He catches the ball and try to get more out of every time, more and more out of every opportunity that he gets.
Second down for the Saints.
We're at second and six. Nowhere to go up front.
Continue up the middle.
Third and around 6 yards to go. Third and around six to go.
Carry, followed by a Hoosier Saints. Loss of a yard on the play.
Sit down and have the ball. First and 10. The ball's on the 32-yard line.
Thank you.
That's a great point.
Number one. Tackle by number one. Wilson.
Great play on 1-1 free safety. He's an athlete.
Great on the play. And that's the end.